I know for sure that AI has made me a lazier developer, but ironically enough, it's also made me a better developer. I've been using ChatGPT 4.0 and more recently 0.1 preview extensively in my day job at Podcast AI, and I wanted to share my thoughts on how this is positively and negatively affecting me and where I think all this is going in the near future. I don't think AI is going to replace all developers, but if you're in that bottom 30 to 40, maybe even 50% of developers, that's a scary place to be right now, not going to lie. And if you're a junior developer or trying to break into the industry, I'll give you my opinion on how you should navigate this new world. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. Sometimes I'll flat out write bad code because of my reliance on ChatGPT. And this is what I mean by it's making me a lazier developer, because I don't even try. Like, I'll write out the nastiest, nested, horrible if statement where I'm if letting unwrapping optionals, it's all nested, it's just bad. Because I know ChatGPT will clean it up. But I make sure the logic is sound, right? If this, do that, you know, unwrap the optionals, all that stuff, right? The logic is sound, it works. Like I said, it's just a nasty, nested, unreadable if statement. Then I go to ChatGPT and say, is there a cleaner, more concise way to write this in modern Swift? And 99% of the time, it'll take that 15 to 20 line monstrosity that I just wrote and spit out a beautiful 2 to 3 lines of code that really cleans it up. And I'm like, oh yeah, I could use a for each here, or I could use map, or optional chaining really cleans this up. And this isn't stuff that, you know, I don't know, but again, I didn't even take the time to think about it because I'm relying on ChatGPT to do it. So it's definitely making me lazier, but like I said, it's also making me better. And here's why. It's because it's like I have a teammate showing me their perspective, a different way to do things, or using an API that I haven't used before or maybe forgot about, because, you know, it's impossible to remember every little API or keyword or anything like that in Swift. So it's like having a teammate that's like, oh, here's how I would have solved it. And that's always very enlightening. So it's making me better because it's like a teammate showing me a different way to do things, and now I can add that new skill set to my toolbox. But there is some nuance in that. I believe it's only making me better because I have that 10 years experience in Swift. I've been around the block. I know what I'm doing, for the most part. I can look at a ChatGPT output and be like, oh, that's not right. What are you doing? Or I can look at it and be like, oh yeah, that's clever. I do remember hearing about that API. That's a good use of that, right? I have that ability to discern the good from the bad, because a lot of times it spits out older code. Right, for example, I'm working on an app that requires iOS 18. So I can use the latest and greatest in SwiftUI, Swift 6 concurrency, the observation framework, all that stuff. So when I ask for help on a solution building a feature and ChatGPT gives me, you know, notifications and observers, I know to be like, hey, can you update your answer using modern Swift 6 concurrency? Specifically async stream, I think, is what I need here. And that helps guide the AI to the right answer. But again, I can only do that because I know notifications and observers have been around since the Objective-C days. I know async stream is the new way to do it, right? I have all that background knowledge. Like, I can only imagine how frustrating it would be to, like, not have that background knowledge and just take what ChatGPT gives me, have to copy and paste it and, like, cross my fingers and hope it works and then not understand what's going on. I can only imagine how frustrating that is. But for a senior developer who has that prior knowledge, this is like giving you a superpower. It's like having an army of the most competent, hardworking, insanely fast junior devs or interns, whatever you want to call them, who are oftentimes smarter than you in a lot of areas at your disposal. Like I said, the only trick is that as the senior developer, you sometimes have to correct mistakes or guide the AI in the right direction to get the best answer. But again, it increases the productivity of one senior dev just immensely, especially when it comes to those long, tedious tasks, which are pretty common in programming, like those become a breeze. For example, I was working on a feature where we did podcast rankings by country, by category, and by subcategory. So you can imagine all the permutations of every country, every subcategory, all that stuff. That is very long and tedious. This feature probably would have taken me a couple days had I had to do it, you know, by hand, so to speak. And I'm talking about things like getting the country code for each country, matching that up with the Unicode so I can have the emoji flag next to the country name, and then breaking down each category and subcategory into a nice enum so I could use it in pickers. Like I said, this task would have taken at best a few hours, at worst a couple days. ChatGPT was able to help me finish this feature in like an hour. Like, it was mind-blowing. So yeah, it's helpful in tasks like that, but can it build whole apps? I'm sure you're hearing the narrative that, like, you know, software developers are going extinct. You're going to be able to prompt the AI and it's going to build an app for you. To be honest with you, I just don't see that. I mean, anyone who's built even a slightly complex app, you understand the complex puzzle it takes to connect everything and make everything work. And if one small little thing is off, the whole thing breaks. And I'm happy to be wrong about this someday, but again, I just can't see someone with no coding experience being able to just prompt an AI and build a complex app. I just don't see that. Maybe I'm a Luddite. Who knows? I'll be proven wrong in the next year, maybe, but that's hard for me to see at this point in time. So I don't believe software developers will go extinct. Well, not all of us, anyway. Because like I said, I think this gives developers with existing knowledge superpowers. So I think it's going to take less developers than are needed. For example, let's say an iOS team has 5 iOS developers. I think you'll be able to just let the bottom two go now that the top three have superpowers and you're good to go. Now, of course, every company has different dynamics, but the point is that your team can probably shrink. So I don't think AI is going to take all of our jobs, but I think it will take a good chunk of our jobs. And like I said in the intro, if you're in that bottom 30, 40, 50% of developers, I just think that's a scary place to be over the next few years. So for you junior developers out there, or people just trying to break into the industry, how do you navigate this new world? Because it's undeniable. ChatGPT can do what you do faster, better, cheaper, like $20 a month. Like, you're not gonna work for $20 a month. So what do? How do you navigate this? Well, again, I go back to my bottom 30, 40, 50% of developers. Like, I believe the bar has been raised. Like, flat out, to put it simply, the bar is higher. No longer can you be mediocre at your job. I just go for the 9 to 5, the paycheck. I do the bare minimum to get by. Like, those days are over. So if you're a junior dev or looking to break into this industry, that's my recommendation. Really take the time to learn, practice, hone your craft. You're gonna have to become really good at this. Because like I said, the bottom 40% that are just mediocre, just doing the bare minimum to get by, that's just not gonna cut it anymore. So a great way to hone your craft, practice, get better is to build a lot of smaller apps, smaller projects. And I always recommend the best way to showcase that work, show people what you can do, is to have an online website portfolio showcasing all your apps. And that brings me to today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform to help you get that iOS developer portfolio up and running very quickly. Now I know, we're developers, we can build the website ourselves, but we're also iOS developers, and I would argue there's an opportunity cost of your time. Now, do you want to spend your time learning about web development, responsive design, all the different browsers, or do you want to spend your time building apps? So that's why I always recommend letting Squarespace take that off your plate to build your iOS developer portfolio. They have all kinds of beautiful themes and templates to get you started, and you can use their next generation website editor with the Fluid Engine to just really unlock all the creativity in the world. You can even use Squarespace Blueprint and Squarespace AI to help you figure out what to write on your website, because that's always the hardest part. Like, I don't even know what to say here. Throw it into Squarespace's AI and they'll help you out. They handle all the SEO and analytics for you. Again, Squarespace handling your website just takes so much off your plate. So when you're ready to get started, go to squarespace.com. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/SeanAllen to get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain.